Intramurals, it's Lexi. I'm here to give you a Pilates-Barre workout that can be done completely down on your mat. Today, all you're going to need is some type of stretch, or non-stretch, band or strap. And then you'll also need two weights. So I have two 2-pound weights. Feel free to grab something smaller, maybe just a little bit heavier. I would not recommend anything greater than 5 pounds. If you don't have weights, you can always grab soup cans, vegetable cans, or you can grab bottles of water. So like I said, our workout today is going to be done completely down on the mat. Just a few things before we get started. I recommend that you work within your ability zone, but then also kind of work right on that line of your comfort zone. So try some new things today. My one rule is always try it at least once, and then if it doesn't suit you today, that's fine. You can skip it or you can replace it with something else that you like a little bit better. My second thing is that we're going to be doing some work here on our knees or on our tailbones. So if you need a little bit of extra cushion, you can always take your mat. You're going to lift it up right in the center and then you fold it over, kind of like you were folding towels or folding jeans. So that's always an option as we move along as well. So we'll go ahead and get started just with a little bit of some dynamic movements and stretches here. You can go ahead and grab that band that we were talking about. And then you want to bring it somewhere that's about shoulder distance or a little bit wider. So completely up to you how wide you take it, but you want it about shoulder distance. So go ahead and bring your hands to grab your strap or your band, whatever you're using. And then you're going to take the palms and turn them down towards the floor. You're going to hold on to your band like you're making a fist. From here, our inhales are going to drive this band all the way up and back so our chest opens. And as you exhale, start to bring it down towards the floor. Inhaling to lift this band all the way up and back. Exhaling to bring it all the way down. So we're going to do this a few more times. You're working at your own pace with your breath, but I recommend letting your inhales and your exhales be nice and long. We're working to start to activate the upper back muscles, the shoulders, and opening through the chest. Our shoulders, upper body, as well as the muscles in the legs are going to be our big focus today. Great. For this last one, we're going to bring it all the way up to the top. Then we're going to start to lean this over towards the left, up to the center, over towards the right. Center and left, center and right. So your elbows are nice and soft, but the arms are extended, keeping the shoulders parallel or in line with the ears. And again, using your breath. So inhale to the center, exhale. Inhale, exhale. You may start to feel the arms starting to burn a little bit, so waking up. Great, we'll take this all the way to the center, and then we're going to start to rotate. So to the left, back to center, to the right, back to center, to the left, to the right. If you're starting to get too much of that burn in the arms, take them parallel to the floor, twisting all the way around. Last one on each side. Bring it back to center. Go ahead and release that strap. So you can bring it down beside you, keeping your weights and your strap close by. We'll grab those later on in class. And from here, we're going to go ahead and bring this into our tabletop. So starting to warm up there a little bit. Find that extra cushion in your mat if you need it. When we find tabletop, we bring the wrist under the shoulders. And again, your elbows are going to be soft, but their arms are extended. And you're going to bring the knees directly under the hips. You have this kind of square shape here from the belly button all the way down to the mat. So you're taking the fingertips, spread them wide because this is going to keep the wrist nice and safe and supported. And then we're going to start to kind of toe tap with the toes. So you're taking the left foot back behind you, pulling it in, the right foot back behind you, pulling it in. So you're just going to start to tap, activating the muscles in the front of the thighs, in the back of the thighs, activating the glute muscles. Taking one more of each. Great, take the left leg, bring it back behind you again. We're gonna start off just here in this half plank position. Again, the arms are nice and supported. You're pressing up through the shoulders, so avoiding the slouch, but pressing the shoulders back behind you. From here, we're gonna start to inhale. You're gonna point the toes, shift your body forward, and as you exhale, start to flex the toes, press the heel down towards the floor. Inhale to press forward. Exhale to press back. Inhale to press forward. Exhale to press back. Good, four more. Nice full breaths. Inhale. Last one. Then we're going to bring this back into that half plank position. So the toes are going to be flexed, almost like you're standing on that back wall under the left foot. So the heel's going to point up towards the ceiling. Stay strong in these arms. Keep pushing through the shoulders. This is also your arm work a little bit here. So supporting and keeping yourself lifted. Pull your belly button in towards your spine so your abs are nice and engaged. We're going to take that heel. You're lifting it up about in line with the shoulder and then bringing it right back down. So this is going to be a little bit different as far as our breath. Our exhale is going to take us up. Inhale is going to take us down. Breath quickens a little bit. Exhale. So again, this work's going to be all in the leg. The core is nice and tight. Not arching through the back as you're lifting up through that heel. Keep pressing. And one, go ahead and bring that knee back in. We're gonna move over to this right leg before we take our recovery. So the right foot's gonna step right back behind you again. We're starting with that warm up. So inhale to point the toes. Exhale, send the heel back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, four more. Last set. Coming back into that half plank, pressing up through the shoulders. Start to lift through that heel. Release. Exhale. Release. Exhale. Release. Exhale. Release. Kept pressing. And one. From here, go ahead and bring that knee in. You're going to take the knees wide towards the side lining. Bring the big toes to touch. So you're sitting your hips back towards the heels. We're going to take our first recovery here. We're coming into child's pose. So two options for your child's pose. You can be nice and relaxed by bringing the elbows down towards the mat. I recommend taking the palms and turning them up towards the ceiling because this is going to give your wrists the best release. Your forehead's going to come right down between the elbows. Option number two is to keep your child pose engaged up through the upper portion of the body. So the abs are engaged, the arms are engaged, the palms come down towards the mat, and the elbows lift. So you're reaching as far as you can, and your forehead comes down to meet the mat. So two options for you here. Feel free to go with whichever one kind of serves you today. If you're looking for that extra push, that extra work in the body, you can keep the elbows lifted. And if you're like, it's time for me to relax my wrist, go ahead and bring it down into a nice, relaxed child's pose. Your way back up. We're coming back into that tabletop. Finishing here with a little bit of abs and a little bit of legs. So we're going to start to work first through bird dogs. And they're kind of not exactly what they sound like, but there's a few different variations of them. So the very first option is going to be to work one side of the body at a time. So typically a bird dog has the opposite arm and the opposite leg extended and working. For our bird dogs today, you have the option to just do the arms or to just do the legs. So again, that's going to be completely up to you. So we'll start here with just working the legs. So the arms, again, the fingertips are going to be nice and wide, wrists are under the shoulders. You're going to take the left leg, go ahead and extend it back behind you. You can flex the toes, point the toes, completely up to you. And then as you exhale, you're pulling your knee in towards the chest. Inhaling to send that foot back. And exhale in. Inhale back. Exhale. Inhale. Two more. Exhale. Inhale. Inhale, send that back, and then that knee is going to meet the mat. We're switching sides. So the right leg's going to inhale back, exhale in. Inhale, exhale. Notice my spine curls a little bit because my belly button pulls in. Inhale, exhale, press through the arms and the hands. Inhale, exhale. Inhale. Exhale, last one. Inhale. Exhale. Bring that back down. So this time we're using the arms. We're going to start with the left arm. So the left arm comes right out in front of you. You're still pressing through that right arm. Reach through the fingertips. Exhale, pull that elbow in. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Inhale, same motion as the legs. Exhale, two more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Bring that back down. Last set, working with this right arm. Inhale, right arm forward. Exhale, crunch. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Two more. Bring it back down. So we're going to work through a few more sets of these, but I'm going to let you do these at your own pace. You do have the option, again, to just do the legs, or you can do opposite arm to opposite leg. So I'm going to be demonstrating opposite arm, opposite leg, but if you want to just do the crunches with the knees, hands stay down on the mat, perfectly fine. So we're going to go ahead and come back into this tabletop. So I'm going to take my right leg back behind me. My left arm is going to go forward. So you inhale to reach here. Exhale, pull the elbow towards the knee. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Two more. Inhale to extend before you take that back down to the mat. And then we're going to move to the opposite side. So left leg reaches back, right arm forward. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Extend that out and then bring it back into your tabletop. Great. So from here, we're going to start to work just on the legs. If your wrists are starting to burn a little bit, you have two options. You can take fists for hands so that your fists come down onto the mat, or you can bring your forearms down just like so. So I'm going to keep my forearms down onto the mat. You can bring the palms down or bring it into prayer hands, your choice. We're going to start to work with this left leg. So you're taking the left leg. You're going to bring the knee to be 90 degrees. You're still pressing through the shoulders, so not slumping, but staying nice and strong. Left toes are going to flex back. We're working through that lower tush. So you're pressing the heel up and pulling it back in. This is your exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Four more. Great job. We're going to start to pull that knee back in. We're switching sides, opposite leg. So the right foot's going to go back 90 degrees from the knee. We're pressing up and in. Four more. Great job. Pull that knee all the way in. Keep the knees in towards one another and then press yourself back into your child's pose again. Remember, you can go active or you can go relaxed. Bring this into a seated position. Anything that feels natural for you, you can sit on the shins or you can rock the legs around and have a regular seat on your mat. You're going to go ahead and grab your weights or whatever you're using for your weight. So again, I have 2 pound weights. You can grab vegetable cans or you can grab bottles of water. So we're going to start to do a little bit of an arm sequence here, and we're just going to start with our weights kind of in our hands. Of course, if you have cans, you're going to be grabbing them whole. If your weights are small enough to where you can extend the forefingers, feel free to, because this is what's going to get the forearms to work just a little bit harder to hold on to those weights for you. All right? So from here, your weights are going to come right out in front of you. So if you see it from the side, I'm making 90 degrees in the elbows, just like we were in the knees just a second ago. And I'll bring this to a profile view. So you're bringing the arms into 90 degrees, just like so. Your weights are right out in front of you. We're going to start to work through a little bit of a push movement. So you're pressing your arms up and down. Up and down. Elbows are about shoulder width. Belly button stays pulled in here because your abs are still engaged, still working. And your arms, your weights go straight up towards the ceiling. They're going to meet right under the shoulders. You keep the shoulders nice down and relaxed. Your weights meet up kind of this 90 degree again. So we're going to start to take the weights down towards the floor, and you're going to bring them all the way up towards the shoulders, and then we're pressing them up towards the ceiling. So in, down, in, up, in, down, in, up. Great. 3 more. So from here, I'm going to turn back to face towards you. You're going to take your arms out beside you. We call this cactus arms in yoga. So So you're going to have your weight to your cans in your hand. Your elbows are going to make 90 degrees. We're going to start to press the weights all the way up towards the ceiling, bringing them in towards the center, and then all the way back out wide. So exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, exhale. For four, three, two, and one. Bring them all the way back down to your cactus arms. We're closing and opening. Close, open, a few more. For four, three, two, and one. Back to those cactus arms, you're squeezing back and down. Down. Down, down. For four, three, two, and one. Bring those arms back up. You're going to reach them out. Last minute burn. Start to circle them back. You can drop those weights anytime. Last little burn in the shoulders here for four. Three, two, and one. Go ahead and take those weights. You can drop them off to the side. Start to roll the shoulders back. So you're feeling all the work that our shoulders has put in. Start to take them forward. Great job here. From here, go ahead and start to take this onto the side body. So lying down sideways onto your mat. You can kind of prop the head up a little bit here as well. You're going to take the heels to meet. You want the heels, the hips, and the shoulders to make one straight line. Your chest and your hips are going to be open towards the front of the room. So you can always bring that right hand down to support you as well. So we're in this kind of sideways lie. Heels are going to come to touch. And from here, we're working with the outer side of the booty, outer side of the thighs. So you're going to start to take the right knee out and in. Out and in. Remember, your work is your exhale here. For four, three, two, and one. Go ahead and bring that all the way down. You're going to extend the legs straight. So you're rested here, kind of on the side body, but you're going to lean forward just a little bit. So making a slight hinge at the hips. From here, you're going to press the feet up. Relax. Up. So you have the choice to keep both legs together or just work one. Two more. Nice, bring that all the way down. We're gonna start to circle this around, so moving to the opposite side of the body. Coming to lean onto the right, you're bending the knees, bringing the heels in line with the hips and the shoulders. Then we're gonna start to work through those clamps. So opening and closing. Open, close, open. Four, three, two, and one. Go ahead and bring the legs back together, extending them out towards the end of the mat. We're going to start to press through those oblique crunches. So press up, up. Thank you. second. Start to roll this onto your back. And bring the feet to meet the mat. Walk the heels and the toes up towards the tailbone. Okay, keep the feet hip distant. Bring the hands down beside you. Roll the shoulders under. So from here, we're going to start to press the hips up and release. Up and release. Keeping the belly button pulled in. Squeeze at the top. Release. Three more. All the way back down. You can bring the legs and extend them towards the end of the mat. From here, we're going to start to finish out with the core. So bringing the hands to meet right back behind the head. Elbows are going to stay wide here. And then we're going to start to work kind of in these bicycle crunches, but we're going to take our time with them, following our breath. So nice big inhales. On your exhale, right elbow meets left knee. Lift the shoulder blades off the mat. Inhale all the way back and down. Exhale, left elbow, right knee. Inhale back and down. Relax. Relax. Bring that extended leg to lift or keep it released down onto the mat. Nice job. Three more each side. Down, bring the knees to meet the chest, start to rock from side to side. From here, the knees are going to go all the way over to the left, take the right arm and reach it over towards the right side of the room. Your gaze is going to follow for a little spinal twist. Bring this all the way up and over, nice and slow, finding it on the opposite side. And we'll bring this up to center, take the feet and let them press down into the mat. From here, go ahead and take the left leg, extend it towards the ceiling. The toes are going to flex down to you. You can hug at the thigh or the calf, but avoid the knee. So either above or below it. You're keeping that leg extended, so we're getting a big stretch to the back of the thigh. Shoulders are going to stay back towards the mat. Now we're bending at the left knee. Bring the heel or the ankle to meet the right thigh. You're going to lift the right leg up off the mat. Pull the right knee towards the chest. You're keeping those left toes flexed back. Bringing the right foot to meet the mat again. Go ahead and switch legs. So the right leg's going to extend, toes flex, hug at the thigh or the calf. So we're taking this ankle to the left thigh, pull the left knee in towards the chest. And then bringing the left foot back down to the mat, followed by the right. Start to slowly and gently lift yourself back up into seated. Again, you're going to come into something that feels more natural for you to sit in. We're going to start to kind of open up and lengthen along the upper side of the body. So the right hand's going to come down beside you. Lift the left arm all the way up and over. Make sure you're creating lots of space under the right ear. The left palm turns down towards the floor. So our extension is all along the left side of the body. We're going to bring this all the way up and over. Take the left hand down beside you. Right arm to reach overhead. Palm turns down again, lowering that left shoulder so you have lots of space under the left ear. And the chest is open. All the way up into center. Go ahead and relax the arm or the hands down to your thighs. We're going to take the left ear over towards the left shoulder. Bringing the chin down to the chest. And then rolling the right ear to the right shoulder. Bring this back up to center. Start to roll the shoulders back behind you. So big circles to release any last bit of tension out. Softening through the belly. Relaxing through the spine, but keeping it nice and tall. Thank you so much, Eagles, for taking 30 minutes out of your day to join me for this gentle Pilates bar workout. Of course, keep your eyes open for other classes, including yoga, Pilates bar, kickboxing, and HIIT. All right, enjoy your week.